He paid a debt he did not owe. We owed the debt we couldn't pay. We needed someone to pay the price for us. Now I can sing a brand new song, Amazing Grace. Lord Jesus paid the debt that I could never pay. I am victorious. Oh yes, we are victorious. Glory be to God, who has given us victory. Hallelujah. We are victorious. Oh yes, we are victorious. Glory be to God, who has given us victory. Excellent Jehovah, marvelous Jehovah, there is no one greater than Jehovah, Lord divine. Excellent Jehovah, marvelous Jehovah, there is no one greater than Jehovah, Lord divine. Our Father and our God, we bless you, we love you, giver of life, ocean divider. And Father, we thank you because you are God. You are King over our lives. Lord, we thank you because you created us. We did not create you. We thank you because you created us for your pleasure. My Father, you made all things beautiful in your time. We give you thanks. We give you praise. Because in every situation, we have every reason to give you thanks. Lord, we bless you. We thank you for this wonderful privilege we have again to hear you speak to us. Our hearts are open. Speak to us in a language we understand, Lord. And let us be refreshed in the name of Jesus. Amen. Beloved, I welcome you to this beautiful month of September. The month that God named for us. Beautiful. He said in this month, he will beautify our lives. Last month, he said that is the month of multiplication. And indeed, testimonies came. Awesome testimonies. You know, you cannot benefit from something you don't believe in. You may have been hearing us make declarations concerning the month, the week, the year. If you don't key to it, you may never enjoy it. You just have to run with the vision. Pick those promises. Wake up every day and give God thanks for giving you the privilege of another day. As you declare concerning your life, that he has spoken again in this month of September, that he will beautify you. Trust God to bring those words to pass in your life, in the name of Jesus. I just want to share with us this morning what I titled, Born to Lead. Praise the Lord. You are not just an ordinary person. God created you in his likeness and in his image. He would have created some other person, but he decided to create you because you are special. You are precious in his eyes. You are a vessel unto honor. Hallelujah. If you were the only one on earth, he would have still died for you. He died for you. Remember, you did not die for him. He chose you. He formed you in your mother's womb. He created you the way you are. He gave you those abilities. He gave you those all those things that you have that you are now bragging about. It's God that gave you. You couldn't have given yourself any of those. Remember, even the debt that you owed, you could not pay. He had to come and pay the price for you. I just want to encourage us this morning. When the Lord gave me this word, I was asking him. I said, Father, what do you want me to say about this? What do you want us to hear? What do you want us to learn? He said, I should go to the book of Judges. And I went to Judges 4. About the story of Deborah. The judge that was under a palm tree. I just want to encourage you. When Israel went astray. After Moses had led them, and Moses passed on, and they handed the mantle, God handed over the mantle to Joshua. Joshua led them, and Joshua passed on. Israel will always deviate from the presence of God. They will always do what God asked them not to do. And so another enemy nation had now prepared themselves that they were going to fight against them. But when the woman by the name of Deborah was consulted, she called Balak. And when she called Barak, she told Barak to prepare himself an army that they are going to fight with the Canaanites. And Barak, a man, said he will not go if Deborah will not go with him. That reminded me about the story of the sons of the prophets. When they said where they were dwelling was too small, and they went and met the prophet, and they told him, they said, "Prophet, man of God, this place we are staying is too small for us. Why don't we go to the other side and extend our place of living and enlarge this place so that it will contain us?" And he said, "Okay, it's a good idea. Go ahead." But the people said, "No. If you do not go with us, we will not go." Thank God they insisted. Because the man that borrowed that ass, I wonder what would have become of him if the man of God did not go with them. Always seek for the presence of God to go with you. You can't do anything on your own accord if the Spirit of God does not lead you. If the Spirit of God is not with you, you cannot do anything on your own. Barak said he will not go except Deborah goes with him. Deborah said, "Okay, now we have this agreement. I will go with you, but the victory will not be credited to you. We will return the glory to God, because God indeed is going to give us the victory." Praise the Lord. You were born to lead. You are a special person in the hands of God. I got some little things written down here as I was studying. And I said here, I said, you must understand that you are not a nobody. You are precious to God. The day you went into that covenant and you accepted Jesus Christ into your life as your personal Lord and Savior, that day was the day everything about your life was redirected. Because you have accepted him, he made you different from the rest. He separated you from the crowd. He distinguished you. And instead of darkness, he gave you light. And wherever there is light, darkness disappears. That is why wherever you go to, you are supposed to set the pace in the name of Jesus. Now don't forget that whenever you are to set the pace, the devil will attack you. Like the Bible says, because you're a special person, 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 8 down. He said, "We are pressed on every side, yet we are not dismayed. Perplexed, yet we do not despair." He said, always bearing about in the body the dying of Jesus, that the life also of Jesus may be made manifest in our bodies. You are not alone in this battle. In the name of Jesus. You are to set the pace, you are to lead. When Elisha was leading, and they had an issue, he told the king what to do. And the other king was angry, and he thought somebody had revealed his secret. And one of them said, "No, there's a man that is always in the presence of God, that even if you say it in the secret, God will reveal it to him. His name is Elisha." And up there where Elisha was in the mountain, the king asked that they should come and arrest him. Thank God for the Spirit of God. His servant was afraid. When he woke up and he saw that the whole mountain was surrounded with armies, with chariots, he was afraid. But I give God praise. Because he that has called us is faithful enough to deliver us from every struggle, from every trouble, from every entanglement. Elisha prayed one simple prayer and said, God should enlighten, open the eyes of his servants to see that those that are with him and with them are more than those that are with in the chariots that came against them. And after God opened his eyes, he told him not to be afraid, because greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. If God calls you to lead, he will equip you. If God calls you to lead, he will direct you. If God calls you to lead, know that you are not alone. You are privileged. You are just an instrument in the hands of God. God wants to show his manifold wisdom again. He wants to express his greatness again. That is why he picks you. Don't look at yourself as if you are a nobody. You are somebody precious in the hands of God. An instrument in the name of Jesus. And when Elisha came out and his servant saw that
the chariot of fire that was around them was much more. Elisha said that God should send down blindness on this Syrian, on these captains of the people that came to arrest them. And all the soldiers, the chariots, blindness came on them. And he took them to Samaria. The Bible says, as a leader, you are not supposed to pay evil for evil. Elisha did not pay them evil for evil. Even when the king wanted to kill them, the king of Israel wanted to kill them, he asked if he should smite them. Elisha said, no, rather prepare for them a meal. He entertained them. He gave them food. You can only overcome when you love. You don't pay evil for evil as a leader. You have to be compassionate in the name of Jesus. Here, and I put down, I said, God wants us to be fearless in this battle because we are not alone. That is where I got the 2 Kings 6, verse 15 to 17. And as a leader, people will disappoint you and you will disappoint people. People you least expect will turn their backs on you, will turn their backs on you. People will talk you down. You will disappoint people and people will disappoint you. You don't have to give up on yourself. Trust God that has called you, that he will see you through in the name of Jesus. Though sometimes it may look as if the veil of heaven and earth has reinforced as a wall of concrete to fight against you. Though things may happen that will make you want to question your faith in Christ. You may have been beaten. You may have been struck down. You may have been discouraged. And you want to just give up. But I tell you something, my sisters and my brothers, there's no reason to give up. Those things are just a test of your faith to make you stronger and a better person. Remember that whatever happens, God knows the end from the beginning. We count from the beginning. He sees it from the end. He knows the end from the beginning. And so in every situation, we should learn to give him thanks. That is what the word of God says. As a leader, no matter what it is that you see, remember that God chose you for this assignment for a reason. I have here Isaiah 62, verse 2 to 3. He chose you to show forth his praise, for his glory to be revealed in your life. Esther looked at herself and saw herself as a nobody. She thought, okay, I have managed to become a queen. She didn't know that she was brought into the kingdom for such a time as this. But when she looked inside, thank God for her uncle Mordecai. She looked inside herself and she decided to take the cross. She said, if I perish, I perish, but I must go fight for this cause. As a leader, you are a fighter. For you to be picked to do the last leg on the relay race, you must be strong. This is the last race. We are in the end time. The devil is doing extra to see to it that we are discouraged, to see to it that the heart of many will fail them. This is the time we have to be stronger. This is the time for us to encourage each other, to stand by each other. We don't have to turn our backs on each other now. We have to work as a team to overcome, for us to get the victory in the name of Jesus. Get ready. God wants to endue you with power. Hallelujah. Remember that Jesus Christ was sleeping in the storm. It was his disciples that woke him up. It was not the storm that woke him up. God wants to endue you with power. His disciples would have also spoken to the storm and decree and declare peace in that storm. But they were afraid. They said, carest thou not, master, that we perish? And they went and woke him up. Jesus, our master, was sleeping in the storm. Hallelujah. I don't know what you are facing. I don't know the storms, the challenges. I don't know the trouble. I don't know the trials you are facing. But I tell you something. Greater is he that is in you. Look inside. You can speak to that situation. In the name of Jesus. He walked on the water. And when Peter bidded him, he asked him to follow. Peter walked on the water. Remember? Until he started doubting. Then he started sinking. Just hold on to that faith. Hold on. You are almost done. You are almost there. Don't give up. No matter the trials of life, no matter what the enemy throws at you, don't give up on yourself. God is with you. He will see you through. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Get ready. God wants to endue you with power. Luke 24, verse 49. Isaiah 40, verse 29 to 31. Psalms 34, verse 10. When you have the power of God in you, nothing is impossible. That is where God wants to bring us to. A place where nothing, we will see every situation we see, we will know that there is a God of that specializes in making the impossible things possible. He looked at Mary. Mary that never slept with a man. Mary that never knew a man. And he said he will conceive. A situation that looked as if nothing, it will never come to pass. It happened. God wants you to set the pace. He wants you to be a leader. He picked you out of the crowd to distinguish you, to make you shine forth, that the darkness that is around you will disappear. I don't know what challenges you are facing. I don't know what pain you are going through. Recently, I lost somebody that is very dear to me. My pastor passed on. But when I traveled for the burial funeral and I came back, my faith was restored. My trust in God was gingered because the testimonies I heard about him gave me hope that we are not fighting a lost battle. We are victorious. Why are we fighting? Why are we fighting? Why are we following Christ? Why are we running after salvation? For us to fight until the end, so that at the end, we'll be given the crown of glory. And I tell you something. There is nothing more glorious. There is nothing more you can desire as a child of God than to fight faithfully till the end. I just want to encourage us that it's not over yet. So there's no reason for us to give up. There's no reason for us to turn our back on the word of God, because his word is yea and amen. His word is sharper than two-edged sword. His word is faithful. His word is yea and amen. He is God. He is supreme. In the name of Jesus, I give you praise, Lord, because you gave me this word and I have delivered it. I thank you. For as many that have not received Christ into their personal Lord and Savior, you may not be able to come out victoriously. But if you want to take this bold step, say this prayer out loud after me. Lord Jesus, I come to you today. I know I've heard of so many things you have done. How that you died on the cross of Calvary for me. Lord, I have come to you. Father, accept me in your fold. I surrender my all to you. Wash me with your precious blood. Sanctify me, purify me. Cleanse me, Lord. Give me a new heart. In the name of Jesus, I give you my all. And I welcome you, Lord Jesus, into my life as my personal Lord and Savior. I cannot do anything on my own, but with you, I can do all things. So, Lord, I trust my life in your hands. In the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you for these ones that have taken this bold step. These ones that have taken this decision to follow you. My Father and my God, in this end time, Lord, pick them out, O God of heaven. Distinguish them from the crowd, O God of heaven. And let your light shine in their lives. Let your light shine and dismiss that darkness in their lives. In the name of Jesus. Do that miracle in their lives, Lord. I give you praise. I give you adoration, because I know that, Lord, these ones are called to lead. That is why you pick them out. You single them out. Lord, I give you praise. I give you adoration in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Son. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Do that which only you will do and take the glory in the name of Jesus. I love you, but Jesus loves you much more. Like I will always tell you, don't stop studying the word of God. Get closer to the Holy Spirit. That is all you need now. You need the word of God much more. You need the word of God, because it's only the word of God that you will use to overcome the devil. We are in the end time. I trust God to see you through. As you study, God will cause his word to come expressly. He will give you the right word at the right time in the name of Jesus. Amen. I love you. See you next time in Jesus' name. Stay blessed. Amen.